What's good, everyone? It's Adam from Imus Mobile. Welcome to a brand new video. Today, we're going to go ahead and break down ESTG's track Backstage Passes with Jack Harlow. So the tempo to this one is 153 beats per minute, and the producers on this one is Pooh Beats and Nick Dean. All right, so we're going to start off with that main lead sort of ARP sound that repeats itself for the entire track. I love these type of melodies because they stick in your head and they're really addictive. So this is the melody on its own right over here. All right, so for this sound, I use Logic's Retro Synth, and I'm pretty much using the default setting that loads up into it with a few parameters changed. For one, the shape two over here is moved to the triangle oscillator. The cutoff is pulled back a little bit to give it a little bit of a filtered sound. I'm pulled up some of the filter envelope right over here, and this is the shape down here. Pulled in some chorus, and that's the amp envelope over there just to make it a plucky type of sound. This is the sound in its dry format. Next up, I pull in a delay. Next, I added in a bit crusher to give it that texture and sort of vinyl character to the sound, analog character to the sound. Then I went ahead and added in some reverb over here. Pulled an EQ just to clean up a little bit of lows to leave some space for our kick in 808 later on. And lastly, pulled in an exciter just to pull out that melody a little bit more. Then from there, it's pretty much just drums. Go ahead and start off with our hi-hat pattern. There's two of them. This is one of them right here over here. So that little roll that you hear in the middle section of the hi-hat pattern is basically just playing around with velocities, and they're just going from the high one all the way down to a low one. The second hi-hat pattern is just a two-step hi-hat pattern without that roll. Next up is the 808. So for the 808, there's a couple of things happening here on the EQ. Just sort of filtered off a little bit everything under 40 hertz, just so that doesn't take up too much room in the mix. Pulled up an instance of Fat Effects just to give it a little bit more of that muffled, distorted type of sound by pulling up the soft clipper over here. I should mention inside Quick Sampler, I pulled back the cutoff as well to give it a darker sound and pulled up the resonance. Otherwise it sounds like that, but in the track it's a little bit darker sounding, so I'm just pull it back to about 60%. This is the second 808 pattern right over here. And lastly, I have an instance of Duckout over here, and this is so that it gives space to the kick once the kick comes in. So every time the kick hits, the 808 will duck out. I'm using the Happy Kick 808 preset, and this is just an algorithm that really makes your kick and 808 to live happily together. Next up, we have the perk sound over here. A couple different patterns sprinkled throughout the entire track, but that's the sound right over there. And then we have an open hat. So one softer one. One lower pitched one, and hits a little bit harder as well. So by doing that, I just lowered the velocity over here, raised the velocity over here, and pitched it down a little bit. Next up, we have that rim shot. So this roll right over here, once again, we're doing a similar technique that we used on the hi-hat, except instead of going down, we're going up. So if I go ahead and pull up the velocity here, you'll see that it's rolling up into that big hit over here. The last sound here in this track is the kick sound. That's pretty much the beat right there. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. Listen to the beat that we just broke down, ESTG's Backstage Passes featuring Jack Harlow. Let's go. So that right there is the remake to ESTG's Backstage Passes featuring Jack Harlow. For your Logic users out there, I will go ahead and save this entire session for you guys. Place it as a downloadable link below this video. I'll also include the playback in case you don't use Logic. That will include the MIDI stems, audio stems, and of course the drum kit that you heard in this remake. You can find that playback down below the like button as well. But on that, if you do have any questions on this, happy to chat down below. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you learned something new, and we'll catch you on the next one. Later. Peace.